were embarrassed the other night?
Yeah, Saturday, I was embarrassed for LSU defense. I was embarrassed for LSU. I mean, we defensive-wise, we didn't put out a great representation of how we practice and how we play. We just didn't do that.
I guess you realized it in the middle of the game, huh?
Oh, yeah. People send me videos of me kind of going off on the defense, but, you know, you ask anybody around here, I'm an emotional guy, passionate and powerful, and a very great competitor. And like I said multiple times, I felt like we were getting dominated. Ole Miss basically, in the second half, they just about did whatever they wanted to do. And that's not how we're supposed to play defense. That's not how LSU defense is played. And like I said, I think I said this Saturday, if we were a bunch of scrubs, if we didn't have the talent that we have, I wouldn't say nothing at all. I just kind of throw my hands in the air and be like, well, we probably need to recruit better. But we have guys that are elite talent guys, guys that can all over the place, the guys that can go first round next year. And we just didn't play like that. We didn't play like that as a defensive unit Saturday. And for me, I just have to let everybody know that's how I felt.
Rashard and Braden were talking about over there, just kind of how Tell the Truth Monday, Coach O and Coach Randall put a lot of that, you know, defensive lapses on them. I mean, just from your perspective, what do you think of that?
Coach O and Coach Randall are always going to put them on themselves. They're never going to blame each other. They're never going to blame the players actually right here in the end zone. Coach Randall, in fact, kind of asked me what I thought. And I told him, I'm like, I know y'all going to put it on yourself and y'all going to blame yourself. But at the end of the day, it's us. At the end of the day, the players are going to have to make the plays. I told Coach Randall, y'all can't baby feed us. Y'all are not going to be able to put us in our gap every play. At some point, we're going to have to make the plays, regardless of the call, regardless of the situation. We're the players out there on the field. We're going to have to make that play.
I guess not only the scoring, but it was like two plays, 75 yards, two plays, 75 yards, one play, 35 yards. I mean, that's just guys just running free.
Huh? Right. And I said this to Coach Bush on Sunday. I came up here and met him on Sunday. When you go back and look at the film, we won on third down. So when that means, what I take from that is, when we made Ole Miss actually have to drive the ball, actually have to play, sit down and play football, they couldn't do it. I think we was 85% on third down as a defense, and that's outstanding. So when you take away those big plays, Ole Miss really didn't have anything. And I hate to say it because you still had to play defense on those big plays, but if you take away those big plays, they really didn't have anything. And I think coming out of halftime, those two plays they took to get 75 yards for a touchdown, and then a two-point conversion after that, it really frustrated me because that, like Coach O preaches, the drive that comes out, the series that comes after halftime is one of the most important series in the game, and we didn't play at the LSU standard performance that series.
All right, where do you go from here?
I think we took a great step today. Tell the Truth Monday. We told the truth. We had an open table today at the defense. We kind of put our emotion out there, what we could have done. The coaches asked what they could do better. And it was really good. Even Coach O said it today. As a team, especially as a defense, we had one of our best Tell the Truth Mondays. We had one of our best Monday practices. And I think that we made improvement. And like I said, kind of brought light to me today Sunday when I talked to Coach O. You know, past LSU teams would have lost the wake-up games. The wake-up games where, you know, we kind of get punched in the mouth and, you know, kind of get jarred. Past LSU teams would have lost. We won. We're 10-0. And we can say that this is a game that we can learn from our experience. You know, we still control our own destiny. And that just speaks to the character of this team.
Jacoby.
Two more for you, Jacoby.
You guys are also getting close to the end of the school semester. How are y'all keeping your grades up being so busy?
That's why we have our, you know, support staff. We have guys at Cox stay with us. We have tutors. You know, we have so many people around us that's going to make sure we stay focused on that end. I know everybody's kind of, you know, up and, you know, excited about the athletic side and winning and all that. But one of the best quotes I heard coming here recruiting said, you're going to have to try to fail if you fail a class at LSU because of all the help and the support cast. Man, the support cast at LSU is amazing. And trust me, they're going to make sure we pass out all our stuff.
Was it good to have Michael Divinity back out of practice today?
Yeah, Mike looked so happy today at practice, man. He looked happy being back. I mean, he enjoyed playing with us. He enjoyed being back with his brothers, and I think he's going to really cherish the times he had with us because, you know, he's seen firsthand that it can be easily taken away. And like I said, I've never seen Mike this happy being with us today.